continue, but others, if you would please shut off your cell phones.
Lo que está pidiendo es que por favor, los que están tomando fotos está bien, hagan lo que quieran hacer, pero los que no están tomando fotos, por favor apaguen su teléfono, nada más para no estar distraído.
At this time, we will have the reading of the recital.
This is a narrative from the kids, the children of James Frederick Russell, United States Navy, United States Coast Guard. You want to translate or am I good?
Él está leyendo uno de los recitantes. Okay, close enough.
No, it's a narrative of your dad.
Un narrato de mi papá.
James Frederick Russell, February 19th, 2018. James Frederick Russell was born in Akron, Ohio, on the 24th of August of 1927, the son of Willard Dale and Lulu May Russell. He had two brothers, Richard and Charles, and two sisters, Dolly and Marjorie. While growing up, James saw the disaster and aftermath of the Depression. He often would reflect, and at times, you could sense his reluctance to talk about those times in his life. And I'm speaking through his children.
Sí. Lo que él está leyendo ahora, yo se lo voy a leer después, ¿ok? Porque corrientemente para traducirlo corriendo es un problema. Pero anoche el lunes yo trabajamos en eso y yo te lo voy a leer a ustedes que no están entendiendo inglés, ¿ok? Yeah, just go ahead and...
For those of you who understand English, what I'm doing is I'm reading from the eyes of his children. So I'll be using the hours a lot, and that will reflect the thoughts of his kids, okay? Our dad remembered and would recount the difficulties of the Great Depression to his children and what he saw and felt during that period, of his life and how profoundly it affected him. He encountered some difficulty in his early years as his family was impacted along with millions of American families. Before going into the Navy, James worked at a Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company in Akron, Ohio, where his father also worked. He worked learning the tire and rubber manufacturing process, and his interest in mechanics has been productive through his life. Our dad always had the affinity to fly. He became interested in aircraft long before volunteering to join the United States Navy and at the tender age of just 17 years old. While he was in the Navy, he worked on aircraft aboard the USS Boxer. Assigned as a sheet metal specialist, having entered the Navy December 12, 1944. He was honorably discharged from the active duty as a sheet metal maintenance man as a petty officer third class on the 19th of July, 1946. Later, as the United States Naval Reservist, he received another honorable discharge from the United States Naval Service on July the 19th, 1950. Our dad spent time in the Western Pacific area of operations while aboard the USS Boxer. My dad, or our dad, never talked too much about what type of action he saw or was engaged in while deployed during the war. He did indicate, however, there was plenty of work to keep us whole, keep his whole department busy. My dad was very active in Boy Scouts, achieving the rank of Eagle Scout, the highest rating in scouting. He then engaged in the Sea Scout program, receiving a discharge from the Coast Guard as part of that program. He was a strong Christian who enjoyed leading his shipmates through difficult times. A strong spiritual counselor, teacher, leader to Christ. Our dad was awarded the Victory Medal and ASEAN Pacific Era Campaign Medal, along with other awards. Our dad felt the call to ministry as a missionary pilot in the Republic of Panama. He received his ordination through the Church of God, but when he arrived in Panama in 1962, he worked with the Home Mission Board, then located in Balboa across from the YMCA, which was the organization whom he worked with throughout his entire missionary career. Our dad helped develop and started the Maritime Faith Mission Fellowship, headquartered in Detroit, Michigan. Our dad flew and maintained small planes, first Cessna 170, then Cessna 185, and ultimately Cessna 206. Departing from the old Paitia Airport of Balboa Avenue to places all over the Republic of Panama, such as Darien, San Blas Islands, Yavisa, and many other locations, to share the gospel. His flight supported 13 Christian-based denominations. His flight that supported 13 Christian-based denomination as a mechanic. He worked, fixed generators and other mechanical equipment as required as he presented the gospel to the people. Our dad would help the missions team carry out their work as well as many other duties, for example, delivering medicines for the missionary doctors whom would donate their time and service to remote locations in the jungle of Panama. His work and dedication to his Lord God improved the quality of life, both physically and spiritually, for many of the Panamanian people. Throughout his 40 years of service, my dad would administer the hundreds of local people and his support to the multitude of missionaries. He would fly into the jungle and return them safe back so they could return home to carry out more work. Due to an airplane crash in the Darien jungle in 1974, he was hospitalized for a 6-month period at Gorgas, including physical therapy, recovery time. After recovering, he once again took up ministry and continued to fly for the Lord. Our dad typically attended the First Baptist Church of Balboa. While the Canal Zone Treaty made many changes in Panama, my dad was steadfast and continued working with Pastor William B.B. in support of the mission. Our dad was most proud of his family and children. They grew up in a Christian home surrounded by love for each other and dedicated to serving the Lord. Our dad is survived by two sons, Stephen Randall and Ted Marshall, and three